Blessed be the name of our God, our wonderful Father, our affectionate Savior, the one who does more than we can ever ask for or imagine. Blessed be his name forever in Jesus' name. Amen. Today we are going to read Psalm 74, verse 19. Psalm 74, verse 19. Oh, do not deliver the life of your turtle dove to the wild beast. Do not forget the life of your poor forever. It's a wonderful description to talk about the turtle dove when it's talking about a person who is relating with God. That you come to that point of becoming God's turtle dove. And how is a turtle dove defined in the ordinary English dictionary? It's defined as a bird that has a plaintive note. The sound is not obnoxious, it's just normal, just, in fact, serene. And it is known to be very affectionate. The disposition of a turtle dove is affectionate. Do you have that kind of disposition towards your fellow human being? Not to talk of towards God. Because we pretend that we have that disposition. And what you can't do for the human being, you can't do it for God. Because as the scripture says, the person that you have seen with your eyes, that's what Jesus said. Do it, start from there. What kind of disposition do you have? Battling, troubling, worrying, quarreling, angry at all times? Are you a child of God? Definitely are not. And can you be called God's turtle dove? Well, the description for you will be contradictory. Because your life does not know affection and true affection, not pretended affection. And then it is noted for its devotion to its mates. That's the turtle dove. If the church is the wife of Jesus and you are that church, what is your devotion to your mates, who is Jesus? How devoted are you to Jesus? Because it's easy to read this time. Oh, Lord, remember your turtle dove. Deliver your turtle dove from wild beasts. You shout, I am God's turtle dove. Does your character suit it? I have brought out the description of the turtle dove. Is that your character? Can you be described in such terms? What's your devotion to God? What's your disposition towards the next human being, let alone towards God? How is your sound? I am not just talking about the ordinary voice. How is the sound of your spirit? What does it bring out? Jarring sounds or plaintive notes that suits everybody? That's the turtle dove. That is why the turtle dove is not offensive to anybody at all. It has a mate so passionate towards that mate, clinging to the mate, so honest to that mate. What is your honesty level to God? I'm not even talking about those two other human beings. What kind of life do you live that you can tell yourself you are God's turtle dove? Because that's the one that God will definitely go out to take care of. You could be poor, you could be rich. The fact that you are God's turtle dove does not all of a sudden mean that you can't be poor. Lazarus was a poor man. He died a poor man, but he went to heaven. So being poor is nothing wrong at all. That was the example of Jesus, Lazarus, the poor man. And anyway, God himself has specifically said, the poor shall always be among you. Jesus concluded the same thing. So the fact that you are poor does not mean that you are not God's turtle dove. That's not what I'm driving at. You might be rich. You can be so stupendously rich. Are you God's turtle dove? And you can be so wretchedly poor like Lazarus. But he was God's turtle dove. And he ended up in the bosom of Abraham. Where will you end up if you call yourself God's turtle dove? But just check the description. If you are God's turtle dove, I came today to announce something to you. That God will never allow the wild beast to overtake you, to overpower you, to destroy you. That the guidance of God, the protection of God is upon you. That the coverage of God is upon you and everything that belongs to you at all times. That whatever you are doing at work, at any form of endeavor in school, anything, you have the coverage of God. And you have the favor of God continually looking down upon you. That is why that turtle dove is protected. The turtle dove, as it were, cannot protect itself, cannot fight like other birds. But it is the owner that takes care of it because of the relationship. What relationship do you have with God? So that he takes care of you. You cannot do anything of your own. You can't fight for your life if it came to that. What do you know about life? You only know the things you see. What about the ones you don't see? He knows. He's your owner. Are you his turtle dove? Indeed, according to the description of what a turtle dove is, if you are, rest assured that things are good for you. Father, every turtle dove of yours, today I raise a hand of victory for them. Wherever they are, no wild beast can consume them. The poor, the rich, whatever situation of their lives, so long as that they are your own turtle doves, they find victory, freedom, liberty in you, and the abundance of joy and fulfillment, contentment in their situations. In Jesus' name, amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit rest and abide with you now and forevermore. Amen.